task in the topographic map lab is to create a topographic map using elevation points given to you. This demonstration video will walk you through those steps, so have a look and then give it a try. The screen that you're looking at now shows elevations across a portion of land surface, and your job is going to be to connect points of equal elevation. Those define contour lines. Before I start a project like this, I usually take a look at the map to get the lay of the land, as it were, and I see a couple of things worth noting. I see that probably the lowest elevation on the map is Wedgwood Lake down in the south portion of the map at an elevation of 42 feet. And as you might expect, as you move away from the map in any direction, the elevations tend to increase going uphill. Here's an intermittent stream shown with the dash and dash pattern in blue, and we would expect that that stream is flowing towards the lake. We can confirm that by looking at elevations. We've got an elevation of 50 feet here, and in this direction on the stream, the elevations get higher and higher up to 100 feet. So that's one general observation. Another thing that I see right away on the map is this little cluster of points over in this area that is a bit different than the other points. I've got several 100-foot elevations and a few 90-foot elevations, but they don't, in fact, they're surrounded by lower elevations on either side. This suggests that there might be a hilltop in that area. So I'm going to be careful when I draw my contour lines in that area. So let's erase what we've put down here, and let's start off drawing some contour lines. When I get started on a project like this, I usually start near a known elevation. In this case, I'm going to start in the south portion of the map because I know this shoreline is at 42 feet above sea level. That defines a shoreline. Everywhere along, it's 42 feet above the sea level. And I see some 50-foot points that I'm going to connect. I'll be contouring this map on a contour interval of 10 feet. So I'm connecting every 50-foot point. And you'll want to remember that when a contour line crosses a stream, it forms a V, and the V points in an upstream direction. And notice that I've drawn this line that goes through the 50-foot points, and everything south of that line is lower than 50 feet in elevation. And I'm going to work with the 60-foot elevation. Again, make a V as I go upstream, cross the stream, stay on 60 feet. And now everything between this line at 60 and this contour line at 50 will be an elevation that is between those two, somewhere between 50 and 60 feet of elevation. Next line will be 70 feet. I'll make a V where I cross the stream. V points upstream. I see 70 foot elevations ahead, so I'm going to connect them. Here comes 80. It'll follow a similar pattern and right off the map. Now, we noted earlier that the 90 foot and the 100 foot elevation might be something to pay close attention to. So when I get to this point, I'm going to stop, because I see 90s ahead of me in two different areas, and I have to decide what to do with that. I'm going to hold off on this point where I just stopped and move over here and connect these 100s in a circular form. That indicates the top of a hill. And once I do that, then I can see that there are some 90-foot points that can also be connected in a circle, again indicating the top of a hill. Now I know what to do with this 90, and that's to skirt around the side of the hill in this direction and off the map. I'll go back to the west side of the map with my 100, connect my 100-foot elevations off the map. Finally, that leaves me one more contour line. Now, you'll notice a couple things here. Contour lines never cross one another because they represent points of distinct elevations. where contour lines close back on one another. They always indicate a top of a hill. And another thing you'll note is that contour lines will repeat each other when you change direction. For example, if I am a little stick man and I'm walking uphill in this direction, I cross the 80-foot contour, continue uphill, I cross the 90-foot contour, continue, 100-foot contour, I reach the top of the hill here, whose elevation, by the way, would be somewhere above 100 feet, but not as high as 120, so I might call the top of that hill at 110 feet. Now I start going back downhill, and notice the first line across is a repeat of the 100, back to 90. But now I repeat the 90 again, which means I've started back uphill and in DSC 96, and finally I would cross 100 feet as I go off the map. So as you complete a map like this, constructing your own topographic map, please work in pencil and work slowly and start off by looking ahead at the general lay of the land.